Are you advocating or imposing as a nurse? Warning, this video may push some buttons today, but truly think about what I will be discussing today. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel, Nurse Catherine here. Before I get this maybe controversial video started, do not forget to subscribe to my channel, give this video a big thumbs up, and hit that notification bell. But other than that, let's get this somewhat, maybe, I don't know, really controversial video started. To the historic nurses that I learned about in nursing school, first I think of Florence Nightingale. I remember reciting with my little white lamp here at the award ceremony the Florence Nightingale pledge. Specifically in that pledge, I remember this part. And as a missioner of health, I will dedicate myself to devoted service to human welfare. And secondly, I think of Florence Wald and what she did for patient advocacy. She was known as the mother of the modern hospice movement. She originally saw how bad hospice patients were being treated. And as she was dean at the Yale School of Nursing, she made curriculum changes. These changes focused on end-of-life issues. Through these curriculum changes, nurses now understand the importance of a patient's dignity, the importance of freedom of pain, and also the importance of autonomy. There is not one nursing school that I know that does not teach these matters. So now I ask you, as you may be 1, 2, 5, 25 years into your nursing career, are you still advocating for your patients, or are you imposing your beliefs on your patients and their health decisions? I see such a need to bring this subject up right now with the season of life that we are in here currently in America. Not only is this important now, but it has always been important. But why do I bring this up now? Because I am seeing nurses all over the internet and in person say, this is the right way and the right way only. No other way is right. We are to support our patients no matter what, right? We are to allow them to make their own health decisions, right? We are to continue doing CPR on that 102-year-old and not question their living will, right? And we have to be okay with these autonomous decisions, right? But that is not what I am seeing anymore. I hear opinions about these choices. Eye rolls during CPR, coercion, and not fully educating patients on risks versus benefits of certain procedures or surgeries. This is real and this is actually happening. So I am here to ask you today, are you advocating for your patient, or are you imposing your own beliefs on what you think is right for that patient? Are you fully educating your patient, or are you only giving them some of the risks or some of the benefits so they do what you want them to do? Are you getting mad and unfairly treating this patient because they did the opposite of what the doctor recommends? Are you okay with that 20-year-old who just signed a DNR form and you don't think that was the right choice to make? Or are you okay when a mother gives birth to her fifth child and signs a full code document when there's only a 2% survival rate for that child? You may be a nurse, but are you being a faithful nurse? Faithful to your profession and faithful to your patient. I am seeing this dwindle away in the nursing profession, and I will be the first to admit I have fallen to my sin and I have not advocated for my patients properly. And I'm here to ask you, are you advocating or are you imposing? So what does a nurse advocate look like? Well, comment what you think that looks like below. What do you think it means to be a nurse advocate, a nurse patient advocate, a patient advocate, whatever term you want to use, what do you think that looks like? Not only do I want you to comment that, but also comment what you think can be done to change this culture in nursing. Other than that, that is it for today's video. Thank you for tuning in and thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell. Other than that, that is it for today. Thank you for tuning in, and I will see you in Tuesday's educational video.